Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know, I'm doing pretty great today too because it's time for some changes. So, a little bit of story time here. I've had this MacBook Pro for about 6.5 years. I remember ordering it right after the keynote address. I was so excited for it. I was getting it for school and I had a scholarship to help pay for it. And I thought to myself, you know what? I'll have it for 2 years. Be done with school or whatever, and then just move on to a new laptop because I usually upgrade it every 2 years or so. Well, it's been 6.5 years and I still have it now, but I kind of need some input because I think it's time to move on from it soon. So a while ago on Twitter, I posted a little tweet that talked about two potential options for how I want to proceed going forward with a new daily driver. And I do appreciate all the responses, seriously, so I thought making a little episode about this topic would be great too, because I value your guys' input and ideas. So I'm thinking, do I either A, wait for the 16-inch MacBook Pro to get another update in, you know, 5-6 months or whatever, and I get a notebook, and then use this as a backup machine, or B, do I wait for the iMac to get updated, and then use this as like a field machine? So it's kind of desktop versus laptop right now. The iMac is rumored to be coming out with an update sooner than the MacBook Pro because it's been about a year since the last iMac refresh, and it's been, what, 8 years since the iMac had a design change? And there's rumors that the next iMac is gonna have some design changes, which is pretty sweet. In fact, one of the concepts going around was this one, and I thought it looked cool, maybe a little impractical, but still pretty cool. I do admire how it kind of mimicked the Pomona and Sweep designs from the early days from the Apple Industrial Design Group. Not sure if that was on purpose or not, but kudos to you. Anyway, the next iMac is an option. And the reason why I'm thinking desktop is because laptops can be a little more expensive at times because you're paying for other things. You're paying for batteries, you're paying for miniaturization, whereas with the iMac, I think you can get a little more bang for your buck because you're not paying for the portability. But then you lose the portability. But if I still have this computer, I can maybe use it as a field machine. The other advantage with the iMac is there's different I/O on there still. In fact, the current iMac, even the iMac Pro, still has USB Type-A. The MacBook Pros do not. So I'm kind of torn between the two options, but I'm open to suggestions on which one I should go with, and if you have a different idea, let me know. And I get it. Everyone has their own opinion, but I don't want to switch away from Apple. I've used Windows for years as my daily driver, but I just like Apple, and they've been my daily driver for a long time. Okay, so the longevity is great and all that stuff, and this computer has been with me through so many Krazy Ken episodes, and it's been so much fun. Well, why have I held on to it for so long? Well, one, money. Like, why spend the money if I don't need to, right? And two, Apple's butterfly keyboard fiasco, that was freaking terrible. I didn't want to buy a computer where the keyboard might just fail. I've heard too many horror stories. And the other thing too was dongle city. Like, I know it's important. We got to move to USB-C and Thunderbolt 3 and all that jazz. One thing I do want to talk about though is how I was able to stick with this computer for so long. So the main thing I do is video editing. I use Adobe Premiere Pro and I use Final Cut Pro. But primarily on this machine, I use Final Cut Pro. And since Final Cut Pro is made by Apple and I shoot in ProRes, which is an Apple codec, everything is so optimized. Final Cut Pro's speed is so darn fast, I was able to get so much longevity out of this machine. In fact, I did a couple videos on this subject in the past where I showed how fast Final Cut Pro's rendering and playback performance is compared to Premiere Pro. And that is one of the big reasons I was able to stick with this computer for so long, because Apple's software was super optimized. So I encourage you to think a little bit before you're about to spend a bunch of money on a hardware upgrade. Maybe you just need to use a different program that takes advantage of your hardware better. But at the same time, that can kind of go the other way around because some software is freaking expensive. Thankfully, Final Cut Pro is cheap and you don't pay a subscription model, unlike with other programs out there. Right, Adobe? So why do I now need to make the change if everything has been fine until now? Well, I'm kind of pushing the boundaries of this thing just a little too much. For starters, there's no HEVC, hardware accelerated encoding, anywhere in the system. So if I want to use H.265 for high quality video that's half the size of H.264 video, good luck. It takes forever to render on here. The other thing is too, I'm starting to shoot a lot more in 4K. So just for example, my Sounds of Isolation video where I made that song out of all the computer noises and stuff, that was a lot of simultaneous streams of color graded 4K footage. The computer could not keep up with that. I had to generate proxy files just for playback because it was dropping frames. So the more I do with 4K, the more it's really starting to just slow down. Even when I'm rendering 4K, other parts of the system, like just even window animations, will start lagging because it's just getting pushed too far. The other thing too is, and I haven't milked this a bunch yet, but live streaming. I want to do more with live streaming, and you need a faster computer to be able to keep up with encoding the camera in real time, not dropping frames, making sure the audio's in sync, loading animations in real time, because when you're streaming live, everything has to be rendered in real time. It's like a video game. You don't have time to render stuff. It has to be done in real time. And if your computer can't keep up, you're gonna drop frames, maybe lose the connection to the stream, and it would be terrible. And since I wanna do more webcasts going forward, I'm gonna need faster hardware to keep up. But this thing has served me well, and I still plan to use it. Even if I get an iMac, it'll be a field machine. If I get another MacBook Pro, this can be a backup machine. It's still a great computer. So let me know what you think. I'm open to your input. Because this is a pretty important thing. I mean, think of all of the episodes and stuff you've watched from me in the past like 6 years. They were all edited on this computer. So getting a new daily driver is a pretty important thing for the future of the Computer Clan and Krazy Ken's Tech Misadventures. Thanks for sticking with me. Catch the crazy and pass it on.